JBN, we keep you informed. I am Michelle Jones, and in the news, survivors recount their brush with death after high-speed chase by gunmen in Manchester. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items. When a vendor set out to ply her wares in the Christiana Market two Saturdays ago, she had no idea that the truck in which she was traveling would have become the target of gunmen in a high-speed chase through the countryside. The random pickup from a butcher heading to purchase cows at the animal market in the Manchester town was the beginning of a dramatic episode that ended with the two fleeing for their lives in bushes after the attackers sprayed the vehicle with gunfire, hitting her several times. That brush with death is a rarity in the quiet North Manchester region, a hodgepodge of bustling vendors and sprawling farms famous for tubers like potato as well as other cash crops. The vendor, who requested that your name not be mentioned because of security fears, said that they sensed danger when a taxi whizzed past them in Walderston. It was the same vehicle they had passed early on when they were approaching Penhill. She said the driver of the car slowed down, switched on the hazard lights, and appeared to indicate that he might be having mechanical problems. But the butcher, who has been the victim of road robberies twice before, smelled a rat. Years ago, he escaped robbers who tried to block the road in Lawrence Tavern, St. Andrew, but not before a single shot was fired in his direction. But the 5 a.m. Manchester attack, he said, was far worse. The butcher said he had also been spooked by tales of robbers pulling people over or staging an emergency in Walderston. He had one intention, floor the accelerator. Me was surprised when me come to Walderston Square. Me said the car overtake me and go over upon the left side and I fan me down. But me not stopping for nobody, the butcher, who also requested anonymity because of safety concerns, said in an interview. About 9 shots were fired at the truck, blowing out the 2 front tires. The market vendor, who is in her 40s, could not believe she was in a real-life horror movie. Just as I asked him if those were gunshots, the truck swerved as the taxi was right at his window trying to undertake him, she said. The vendor theorized that the attackers may have had knowledge of the butcher's plans to make purchases at the market. Them rob him already. And how them chasing the vehicle, you know they're after something. They wouldn't stop, she recalled. As we were going to pass, them fired shots directly at the truck from the passenger side. The woman, who took cover on the floor of the truck, said she felt numbness in her fingers and soon realized she had been shot when blood began to flow. By this time, the truck shoot up and the tires them gone now, but we managed to drive a distance away from them. The driver wanted to go to the police station, but me tell him no, as he'd be expecting us to take that route, she said. I said to him, let us take a detour, because we can't manage to have them catch up on us again and overtake us again. After abandoning the truck at the Chudley service station, they dashed into the bushes. While we were there, we hear a car speeding down and we knew it was them. I had left a backpack with my dirty clothes, my phone, and about $400 in the truck, which they made off with, she said. The vendor used the driver's phone to call a relative, who then summoned the police. After me leave the police station and go to the hospital, me realize how much shots me get. There were 3 large holes in my side, and the doctor said that was where the bullets enter and exit, she said. The vendor revealed that the bullets hit a nerve and that the motion in 2 fingers is now compromised. Resented the prospect of undergoing therapy, she's relieved that the butcher had not been shot during the chase. The butcher said that he's happy that he took the advice of his passenger not to head to the police station, but to abandon the vehicle near the service station in Chudley. 2 more minutes of driving, he said, could have cost them their lives. 12 days after their harrowing experience, the butcher is oozing gratitude that he survived because of divine intervention. I just my faith in a God and my confidence. Any homie did lose confidence more than dead, he said. The attackers had struck hours earlier, boarding the taxi in Mandeville on Friday, May 14, at approximately 8 p.m. While en route to Mayday, the men pulled their guns and demanded that the driver head to Christiana. It was there that the gunmen tied up the taxi driver and a passenger in bushes, while 2 of the men made off with the vehicle and 1 stayed behind to keep watch. When they were released on May 15, the cabby and passenger traveled to the Williamsfield Police and reported the matter. Superintendent of Police Gary Francis, commander of the Manchester Police Division, said no one has been taken into custody in relation to the crimes. Violent crime has fallen in Manchester this year, with declines of 40% and 25% in murders and shootings, respectively, up to May 19. The butcher, who has been traveling to the cow market in Manchester since 1991, warned that criminals are scouting for prospective victims under the guise of being customers. Them are going to come back, and the comeback will not go worse than this, he said. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember, subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.